just 100 days to go and no consensus. Britain's exit from the EU is set for the end of March, but the British public and its politicians are so divided. One side sees Brexit as a catastrophe and the other as an opportunity. And no one seems in the mood to make concessions. Still, Prime Minister Theresa May says her government's working to ensure a smooth transition.
Negotiations like this are always tough, there are always difficult times, and as you get close to the, you know, the very end, then that can get even more difficult because you're absolutely sorting out the last details of something. But this is what drives me to carry on doing this and making sure we deliver, is that this is what's right for the British people.
But the clock is ticking, and there's been little progress in getting a Brexit plan through the British Parliament. So both the EU and May's government have started to prepare for a no-deal Brexit. Many multinational companies headquartered in London argue a departure without a deal would be catastrophic for the British economy. And pressure for a second Brexit referendum is growing from an opposition that wants the UK to remain in the EU.
Asking us to vote for a deal when so many crucial issues, notably security, are not yet clear. Asking us to vote for a deal which could endanger not just our economy, but our security going forward. The more you examine this deal, the more it becomes clear that this House cannot vote to support it.
May withdrew a vote planned on her Brexit deal last week and has now moved it to the third week of January. But approval from Parliament still remains unlikely, as even members of her own party have joined the criticism.
I resigned because I thought this is the biggest vote I'll probably ever vote in my political career. It is for each member in this House to decide what they do. But for me, the national interest is not served by voting for the government's motion.
Public support for a second referendum appears to be rising, according to polls in the national press. Senior politicians and even former Prime Minister Tony Blair have joined in the call for another vote by the public. In the meantime, May is battling to maintain her authority as Prime Minister after surviving a recent vote of no confidence. She and her cabinet have dismissed the idea of another referendum, saying it would be a disaster for British democracy. So, will May's government be able to secure a deal to leave the EU? And is a second referendum really undemocratic, even if Britons have changed their minds? Shoaib Hassan, The Newsmakers.